What's good, y'all? Rich Sosa back in the building, and today, as y'all can see by the looks of the title and the screen, today I'm going to be bringing y'all the first ever top three best two-way small forward builds coming at y'all on NBA 2K21 Next Gen. So y'all are most definitely going to want to stick around, because a lot of these builds are definitely going to be overpowered. And when it comes on top of all that, the lockdown is going to be in them as well. So man, as y'all can see with the first build that I got lined up for y'all, going to be called the two-way mid-range facilitator. But before we get into the making, man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. To the Rich Gang family and any new supporters, I'm telling you right now, if y'all go ahead and hit that like button, that helps me out so much and I would truly appreciate it. Be sure to turn on post notifications so y'all do not miss when I upload every single day. And last but definitely not least, y'all, be sure to share this video with your family and friends. Now let's go ahead and get into the making of this first build. The two-way mid-range facilitator is actually going to be a very nice build when it comes to the small forward position. I'm telling you, when it comes to next gen, the small forwards got a huge buff as well as the power forwards. So when it comes to this build, I'm going to go with 6'8". When it comes to the weight, I'm going with 185. And then when it comes to the wingspan, I'm going to go with 7'6". You could adjust these to your liking, but I'm telling you, the way that I'm setting up this build is honestly going to put you in the best position to get success. So let's go ahead and get into these physicals. The very first thing that I'm going to go ahead and do is put the stamina on this build up to a 91. This is only one of the ways that you can make this build. If you want to, you can definitely go ahead and change up the stamina. But for my liking, I'm going to go with an 80 vertical. I'm going to go ahead and skip the strength. But when it comes to the speed and acceleration, I'm maxing out both of these, y'all. Now let's go ahead and get into the defense. So when it comes to the defensive rebound, I'm going to go ahead and put that to a 68. When it comes to the offensive, put this to a 66. Then when it comes to the block as well as the steal, both of these are going to be maxed out. Then the perimeter defense, going to be maxed out as well. Or you could go ahead and lower it to your liking, but I'm telling you, the 23 Badgers right here is honestly going to be very useful. Now let's go ahead and get into the playmaking. As you can see, we're going to be maxing out the speed with ball, ball handle, and then the pass accuracy. We're getting 20 Badgers right there, so honestly a really good setup so far. Let's go ahead and get into the shooting now. The free throw is going to go up to a 46, but when it comes to the mid-range and the three-pointer, we're maxing out both of these for 8 Badges. Now let's go ahead and get into the finishing. As you can see, the post control is going to be an 83. Driving dunk is going to be a 95, and the driving layup is going to be a 94. Now the rest of these attributes, feel free to touch them and put them on based whatever you want to go with, except the finishing. If you do that, as you can see, you're going to be able to get an extra 2 badges on the finishing, but that is definitely going to change up the build name, and that is what we don't want. So as you can see, when it comes to the defensive side, you can even make a couple of extra adjustments right here. But if you do not want to, again, it really comes down to your preference. Like I said, even the physicals can be changed. So whatever you feel like doing, go ahead and go after it. Really, you should try to take some risk when it comes to this build if you want to maintain at least the 72 defensive rebounds, so that way you could hit the 80s when you get boost as well as grind this build out. That is also another thing that you can go about. If you want to get the 91 vertical, go ahead and switch up the stamina and the vertical stats and you're going to be just fine. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at these takeovers. As y'all can see, we get the slashing, playmaking, lockdown, and the post scoring, not a surprise here. So whichever of these that y'all decide to pick first, all of them are really going to be pretty good. But with my preference, I'm telling you, the slashing is going to be a very nice one to use, especially for this kind of build. The second one, y'all already know that I would highly recommend picking the lockdown takeover. That's what I'm going to go with. And as y'all can see, we have made the two-way mid-range facilitator with Scottie Pippen comparisons, y'all. Now let's go ahead and get into the next build that I got lined up for y'all out of the small forward position. Again, the two-way finisher, but with this build we are actually going to be getting the post scoring takeover. So Something special about this build, honestly, is the takeover. In past years, the two-way finisher did not get this takeover. It was pretty much the slashing or only the lockdown. And with this one, we get an offensive finally. That is something that I really like about it coming at y'all on next gen. And on top of all that too, this is just another really good lockdown that we can use out of the small forward position. A lot of people really love to go to the power forwards for every lockdown build just because of the bad setup. But I'm telling you, once y'all see this and how it comes out to be once you grind it out, definitely going to be worth your time to make as well as use in the stage, in the rec, whatever game mode you decide to play. I'm telling you, this build is going to be perfect for it. So if y'all made it this far, just go ahead and let me know what y'all thought about that first build in the comment section. Y'all most definitely know that I got y'all. But also, go ahead and let me know what position y'all want me to go after when it comes to these top three builds. If you want a top five, go ahead and drop a like right now. Y'all most definitely know that I got y'all. But if you're still watching, be sure to hit that sub button if you're new, man. I'm telling you, you are not going to want to miss any of the content that I'm dropping daily for y'all. So let's go ahead and get into it now. When it comes to the two-way finisher, of course, we're making it under the small forward position. Then, when it comes to the height, I'm going to be going with 6'8". And then when it comes to the weight, I'm going to be going with is 230, and the wingspan is going to be 7'6". Now, when it comes to the body shape, to take up the most space and look the biggest possible, go with the body shape of Burley. I'm telling you, definitely going to pay off in the long run, especially when you are guarding ball or when people are trying to go up against you. Now, let's go ahead and get into these stats. So we're going to go ahead and start it off with the finishing. As you can see, with the driving layup, this is going to be a 92 and the driving dunk is going to be a 95. Then to get that post scoring takeover, go ahead and max out your post control and put that standing dunk to a 38 for 17 badges. Now, when it comes to the shooting, we're going to go ahead and put the mid-range shot to an 82. 3-point shot's going to be an 81 and the free throw is going to be a 92 for 14 badges. This build is really crazy, especially when it comes to the versatility. As you can see, we are definitely going to be able to shoot as well. Then when it comes to the playmaking, go ahead and put that pass accuracy up to either to where you get 8 to 9 badges or even 10. But if you want to go ahead and save it for the defensive side, you definitely can do so. But when it comes to the ball handle, we're maxing that out. And the same thing with the speed with ball. Gonna end it off with 7 playmaking badges. And let's go ahead and get into the defense now. So when it comes to the perimeter defense, we're maxing that out. Go ahead and put the steal to a 79. Max out your block and max out your defensive rebound. And that's gonna bring us up to 26 badges. Now on the physicals, our speed is gonna be maxed out as well. Acceleration too. Strength, vertical, and then on top of all that, we are leaving the remaining for the stamina, which is going to be a 74. If you want to go ahead and change some of these stats up, feel free to do so, but I'm telling you, we get a crazy amount of defensive badges. And then when it comes to the finishing and the shooting, that is super well balanced. And then you could even get up to 10 playmaking badges on this build, y'all. Gonna be super crazy, especially once you grind it out. As you can see with these takeovers, we get the post scoring, glass cleaning, lockdown, and the slashing, y'all. Whichever of these that y'all decide to go with first, gonna be completely up to y'all. For my liking, I'm gonna go with finishing moves first. The second takeover, see the future, is gonna be a really good one. But honestly, the lockdown is really good too, so neither of these is the wrong decision. As y'all can see, we have made the two-way finisher, y'all. I'm telling you, the builds continue to get better. Another two-way coming at y'all out of the small forward position. Two down, that means we got one more to go. Let's go ahead and get right into it. And as y'all can see, we have got the two-way tempo pusher. Now when it comes to this build, as you can see, we are going to be 6'7", but the weight is going to be a huge factor on this build because we are not going to be going with the minimum. We actually want to be able to use this build and put some strength on it. And that is actually another version of this build that you can go with so you are not weak. And on top of all that, you are 6'7". A lot of the guards that like to be 6'6", 6'5", and even 6'4", do not have any strength. So you are going to be guarding them super easily and you're going to have a huge defensive advantage on them. So if y'all are still watching, just know that I truly appreciate y'all who are here. Just know that y'all are already a part of the Rich Gang family. And if you are still here, just be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Be sure to hit that like button. Really helps me out so much. And last but definitely not least, y'all, go ahead and turn on post notifications. That helps me out the most. Now, let's go ahead and get into the making of this build. So really quick, when it comes to these small forward positions, I do not think that it's a coincidence that every single year we are able to make some of the best lockdown builds out of this position. So when it comes to the height, as y'all can see, I'm going with 6'7". Weight is going to be 209 and the wingspan is going to be 7'4". And as you can see, the potential on the strength is going to be a 72. Max is built out completely to 99. And you get that gym rat badge. Your strength is going to be in the 80s at 6'7", y'all. Now, when it comes to these stats, you definitely want to be sure that you follow along exactly as I make it. So when it comes to the stamina, this is really going to be optional. You don't have to do it, but with my liking, when I first made this build, I went with the 91 stamina. So that's what I'm going to leave it as, just to maintain the build name. Vertical is going to be a 91. Strength for this version of the build is going to be skipped, but if you want to, you could go ahead and max it out. Speed and the acceleration are both going to be maxed out. Same thing with that defensive rebound. And then when it comes to the offensive, bring it up to a 78. And then the block is going to be a 93. We're going to go ahead and skip the steal, but when it comes to the perimeter defense, we are going to be maxing this out at 95, y'all. That's actually going to allow us to get 23 badges, which is honestly super overpowered for this kind of build. Then when it comes to the playmaking, we're going to go ahead and max out your speed with ball handle, and then the pass accuracy is going to be brought up to a 79 for 15 badges. Then when it comes to the shooting, what you want to go ahead and do for the free throw is put that up to a 95. Three-point shot's going to be an 82, and the mid-range shot is going to go up to an 82 as well for another 15 badges. Then when it comes to the finishing, max out your post control. Then when it comes to the driving dunk, go ahead and put this all the way up to a 94. Do not go anything higher. And then the rest of the way, you can put that up to your driving layup. And that's going to give us 11 badges right there. We are left with one extra attribute. So you could go ahead and put this on anywhere. But as y'all can see with these takeovers, we get the slashing, sharpshooting, lockdown. And last but not least, of course, we are going to be getting the glass cleaning takeover. All of these are going to be really good. I'm going to go ahead and leave the options up to y'all. But I just want y'all to know, thank y'all so much to everybody who watched the entire video through. Just know that I truly appreciate y'all, and I'm going to continue to bring y'all these bangers. I am going to go ahead and just let y'all make the decision when it comes to these takeovers. And as y'all can see, when it comes to the build name, we finally got the two-way tempo pusher, y'all. Thank y'all to everybody again. But man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. To the Rich Gang family and any new supporters, I would appreciate it if y'all went ahead and hit that like button. Go ahead and share this video with your family and friends. And last but not least, don't forget to turn on post notice so y'all can catch me when I upload every single day. Man, with all that being said, I got one last thing to say. Rich out.